Okay, so what all do you get in a geometry box? So the first companion you're going to meet is the ruler. So this ruler, I'm sure you wouldn't observe it this much, although you've been playing with it for quite some time, right? So it's famous for these little markings that you find on it. It helps us a lot in finding out how big or how long a thing is. It's got little gradations, as you can see, which will basically show you measurements like centimeters, millimeters, and inches. So next, whom do we meet? The compass. Oh, wait, not this one. Ah, that one. This looks better and more like what I want you guys to learn. So the compass, as you can see, has a little pencil here, has another tip over here. This is called the tool tip or the compass tip. Pretty obvious because this is a compass. And this is the pencil tip, obviously, because this is the pencil. And you use this to do a lot of stuff, like measure length, to draw circles, arcs, all of that. And that's what we're going to learn a bit later. Right now, I'm just introducing you to these guys who are going to help you out, okay? And next, we've got something called the set squares. Now, set squares look something like this. So you get two kinds of set squares, okay? So this is the 30 or the 60 degree set square, and this is the 45 degree set square. And what these guys do is make it easier for you to draw parallel or perpendicular lines. So what are parallel or perpendicular lines? Pretty simple, actually. Parallel lines are those which go like this. And perpendicular lines are those which go like this. So both these kind of lines share a relationship with each other. In the first case, they're said to be parallel to each other. In the second case, they're just said to be perpendicular to each other. That's it. So what do we have left now? Oh, what is this? It looks like a compass. Remember I told you guys that compasses are used to measure distances or lengths? Well, more accurately, dividers do that for you. So if you use a divider on a ruler, you can accurately fix a distance, which you can then use to verify other distances many, many times. Okay, so the only difference between a compass and a divider is that you're not going to have a pencil tip. You're going to have two tool tips. Okay, as you can clearly see over here. And finally, there's one more person I want to introduce you to, the protractor. So the protractor, as you can see, has markings of angles, right? From 0 to 180 degrees. So obviously, you can use this to measure angles from 0 to 180 degrees. So you may have a question for me. Hey, what if the angle is more than 180 degrees? Well, you get special protractors for that as well. Or you can just flip it like this and use it, right? That's simple. So the only guys left in this box are the pencil, the eraser, and the sharpener. You are pros at this. I don't need to tell you what that's used for, right?
To keep learning with such engaging videos, download BYJU'S, the learning app today.